They are hypocrites! The entire Chuck and Charlie podcast family, oh my god, are they hypocrites. Guys, we got to see a 90 Fiance sneak peek, and in this sneak peek, it just basically just completely showed the fact that Charlie and Chuck and the entire podcast family are complete hypocrites. Here's the deal, finally, you know, Charlie and Chuck and the entire family, Andre and Elizabeth, everyone made it to D.C., to see, you know, Chuck the dad's sister and then his dad too, Elizabeth's grandpa. And they were talking there. The first thing Charlie said, because Charlie did go with his wife, but he flew. He did not take the RV. The first thing Charlie said to his aunt and even to his grandpa was, hey, there's Andre. You can meet him. And then he also was saying, and by the way, this guy hasn't worked in 3 years. He never does anything. And also, he was asking my dad for a $100,000 loan. So obviously, the aunt and the grandpa were just like, who is this guy? Then the funniest thing happened. Because then the dad, Chuck, started talking and he said, well, you know, I do have to say to my defense, my sister was helping me a ton because apparently Chuck moved to Florida like a few, not like a few years ago, but it was like maybe 10, 15 years ago, which is kind of ironic because that was around the time that he couldn't pay child support and actually got arrested. But more on that in a minute. Anyway, it was 10, 15 years ago, it sounds like, he moved to Florida with literally nothing. He admitted that. He had no money. He had nothing but, you know, hard work. But can you guess what the guy did? Because he even came out and just said, I went to my dad, who was sitting there, Elizabeth's, you know, grandpa and Charlie's grandpa. He was, I went to my dad and got a loan. So I was like, wait, what? How did this never, ever, 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 ever get brought up? And what do you think Charlie did? Charlie just shut his mouth. And I said, dude, this guy is a hypocrite. Not that Andre should be getting a loan for any amount from Chuck, because he shouldn't. Go work. Go sell some houses. Make the $100,000. Then there you go. But still, the only thing I have to just say to Charlie and the other sisters is just, ha, because your dad apparently did the exact same thing. And now I can kind of see why Chuck isn't so, you know, he wants to kind of help because people helped him. I don't know what his business is. You know, supposedly it's flipping houses. I don't know if that's true. Maybe there's more weird crap going out. The only thing I'm going to say is Charlie and the sisters, oh my God, are they hypocrites, because their dad did the exact same thing. And for some reason, Charlie is just grasping for straws to make Andre look bad. But it's like, if I was Chuck or Andre, I would just say, listen, dude, your dad did the exact same thing. So guys, the podcast family, I cannot stand these people. I especially cannot stand Charlie. I don't mind the dad. I don't, you know, I mean, I guess Libby, I kind of find annoying. She's kind of just irrelevant. They all the girls think they're Kardashians. Andre definitely has a temper. The dad kind of just sits there. It's not, whatever. I don't really, he's kind of indifferent to me. But they do end up making it to DC. They go to their Airbnb. And of course, let me just, you know, keep in mind, they're in DC, a gigantically huge city, not like some rural suburb area where you can just park an RV at anywhere. And of course, guess what? There was no place to park an RV. That should not be a shocker. Like, have you ever been to DC? Where are you gonna park an RV in the city of Washington, DC? So, you know, it's just stupid. So they go there, it was late at night, and they couldn't park anywhere, so they had to keep driving to get a hotel. Everyone was freaking out. It's just one big huge drama after another, and I cannot stand Washington's family. But then they ended up going to Chuck's, you know, Libby's dad's sister, so Libby's aunt's house, and it was kind of a big fight. I don't know. This Chuck's sister was being real defensive and weird with Andre. She was definitely siding with Charlie, which I can't stand that, because Charlie, to me, comes off as a crybaby, and I was never a fan of Andre or Charlie, but now I'm leaning a little bit, not much, so don't get mad at me, but just a little bit more on Andre's side, because I'm like, this Charlie guy, he just will not stop it. It's like, if you can't stand Andre, stand over there, keep to yourself, be respectful, and shut up. But he always has to start drama, and it's starting to kind of annoy me. So we got to see that in the sneak peek, then we got to see Angela and Michael, and I'll keep them real quick, because I'm just like at my literal wit's end with these two. Basically, Angela screamed, 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 screamed. Then Michael screamed, 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 screamed. We now know in present day, there's about a 99% chance they are still together. But Angela keeps saying on camera, I want to get a divorce and divorce and divorce. I don't know. And I tell you all what, I really don't care. The one thing I'm going to say about this is this. You know, people always say that Andre is too verbal and he's mean and he screams and he shouts. Angela's right there with him. Angela, I mean, I don't know what line you say is like too far when it comes to screaming. She calls Michael. And the thing I want to say too is maybe Michael gives it right back to her. And if that's the case, then they're both wrong. But Yeah, I can't stand her. I can't. I think she's so rude. I think she is mean. I'm not a fan of Angela at all, honestly. Look, here's my thing. We saw Ed scream at Liz, you know, from 90 Day Fiance on the phone. If you don't know what I'm talking about, there was a phone call. Ed was on it screaming to Liz, and Liz recorded the call, and it was very awful and verbal and just not cool. Angela does that same thing every night on 90 Day Fiance. And I legitimately feel bad for Michael. So that's all I'm going to say. Can't stand them. If Michael was smart, he would just divorce her and marry someone normal and have a family and not be with Angela. But it appears that they're still together. And of course, I could say too, maybe the drama was just fake for the show. But I've heard from people that randomly are from the same town as Angela. They've met Angela and they go, no, she's just as crazy in person. So I could be wrong. I don't want to hate or harp too much, but it's like, I can't stand even watching her anymore. So that happened. Then we got to see Mike and Natalie. Mike and Natalie, same just craziness. Basically what happened with that was Natalie has to get that procedure done on her nose. If you don't already know, she has a breathing issue, so she had to get something done. Of course, she refused to tell Michael until the last, you know, literal second. And then when she did tell Mike, she also said, hey, by the way, you know, you gotta pay for it, and also, by the way, you gotta take care of me, because she couldn't take care of herself. But the funniest, craziest, most bizarre thing is they end up going to Seattle. That's where the procedure was gonna be at, in Seattle. They go the night before. Mike and Natalie, what do you think they do? They get into a big, gigantic fight. It's like the same thing with Angela and Michael. I can't stand watching these two anymore. They get into a huge fight. They were fighting like cats and dogs. It was awful. And then Natalie ran off, took Mike's truck, went to her friend Juliana or Julia's place, and then she just went to the procedure the next day by herself, and she refused to call back or answer any calls from Mike. So Mike had no idea what was going on. He finally went to the hospital, the doctor's office, whatever it was, where she was. He found his truck. So that just confirmed he knew that she was there. She ends up getting the procedure, and he basically just takes her home. Natalie never once said thank you. She never said, you know, I'm sorry for cutting you off and ghosting you. And Mike definitely has his things he does wrong. Mike is not perfect. Mike is very weird with his mom. But Natalie, man, I mean, for her to expect Mike to pay for the surgery, take care of her, then ghost Mike, then take care of her again, and it's like, and you're really never gonna say thank you. He ends up bringing her back to his house. He drives her home. He, you know, she says, make me potatoes. She's like crying, and I get it. She's probably, you know, on a little something because she's had a procedure and whatnot, but still, it's like she never said thank you. She comes off so ungrateful, and I can't stand her. I know I'm gonna probably get so much hate from you Natalie fans. I'm sorry. I don't always hate Natalie, but for me, it's like she really just comes off, at least on the show, just so ungrateful. So that's my biggest thing in life. I cannot stand ungrateful people. Oh, then we saw Yara and Jovi. And you know what's really funny? If you go through all these couples, Tiffany and Ronald, Mike and Natalie, Yara, Jovi, I guess there's Brandon and Julia, but then you have Angela, and you know, we have all these couples. The majority of them are not together anymore, or they're on the verge of getting a divorce, like Mike and Natalie, and Tiffany and Ronald, and then, you know, Angela and Michael. I guess you could probably say Elizabeth and Andrea are probably okay, but either way, if you look at Yara and Jovi, oh, they just seem so happy. Jovi came back to America finally after months and months and months of being away. He, you know, he was happy to see her. He was happy to see her, his baby. Everyone was just so happy. Of course, if you don't know, Yara did move all of her stuff. So now they're not living in the city anymore. They're going to live in a suburb, which is in the middle of nowhere. Jovi was kind of thrown off by that, kind of. And I get it. It did look a little bit boring. But hey, you have a kid. You're married. This is what being married's all about, I guess, to a certain extent. Maybe. I don't know. I can't talk. But, you know, so I thought it was kind of cute. I love these two as a couple. I literally almost cried when he got back, because they have a real true love. You can call me stupid, and you can call me dramatic, and you can call me a big baby, but they have real love. She loves him. I don't care. I never thought that was the case, but now the more I see them together, that is just the case. She loves this guy. She is just, yeah, I mean, that's all, y'all. She's in love with him. He loves her. They have a cute family, and I love seeing these two so happy and together. So that I was really happy to see. That was about it. You know, he was kind of weird about living so far off in the middle of, you know, Louisiana now, but I don't think it's that big of a deal. It sounds like it's like a 30, maybe 40 minute Uber drive to the city, which is not close by any means, but it's like if you do ever want to go once a month or once every couple weeks, he could still go. So it's not that big of a deal. I'm happy for these two. And like I said, I literally almost teared up when I saw it go down. Then we got to see Brandon and Julia, and they moved out of, you know, they're moving out of his parents' place. They did sign a lease. And the funniest part was, they didn't tell his parents. So they went and they moved out, or they went and they signed a lease. I can't even talk. They went and signed a lease without telling his parents. Then they went and said, okay, now that we've signed the lease, let's go and show my parents, and then Once they see the place, we'll tell them, hey, by the way, we also signed a lease here. So they did that. They showed them the place and they were looking around. And I have to say, they were nitpicking. The place is very nice. I don't know what they're paying for rent, but the place is very nice, I will say. The thing I'm going to say is this, though. There were a couple things, whereas for me, I could not live there. For one, there's no windows. Like, there are windows that do not even, like, really go outside. They go into, like, these little, like, you know, corridor things. So it's not even like you can really see, like, you know, you can't see anything. You can't see clouds. You can't see the sun. You literally see nothing. To me, I would never want to live there. So it was a nice place. I could never live there. But the parents, they were nitpicking, but they had a couple valid points, like the window thing. Then after they nitpick, Brandon and Julia go, hey, by the way, we signed a lease here. And the parents were just like, oh my God. Ron even said, I think this is totally Julia's idea. It's a bad idea, but it is what it is. It probably wasn't the smartest idea. Maybe they should have looked at some more places. But the thing is, at the end of the day, Brandon and Julia, they needed to move out. They for sure needed to. They should not have stayed, you know, in his parents' place. They're both getting older. They need to move on, do their own life, do their own thing. And so it's good that they moved out. Is it the best apartment? Probably not, but it is an apartment and it's very nice. And so that's all that matters. They're moving out. His parents weren't very happy, but it wasn't this big emotional drama like they were making it out like it was going to be. And then last but not least, I want to say, and if not, everyone else is really boring. I want to say last but not least, am I missing something? I feel like I'm missing something. Maybe not. I don't even know. My mind is just blah right now. We got to see Tiffany and Ronald. If you don't already know, it's not a spoiler. Everyone is literally talking about it. Last week, Tiffany and Ronald called off their marriage. They're getting a divorce. It's over. It's done. So now we're kind of watching them and like, it's like, oh, okay. It ruins the fun because we're watching them thinking, okay, well, we know in a couple months they're going to be, you know, getting into a huge fight and getting a divorce. Basically, what happened was they fought and they fought and they fought and they fought. Kind of like Angela and Michael. Kind of like, you know, Natalie and Mike. It's the same thing. It's so annoying. So they were fighting and fighting and fighting. She's still in South Africa. You know what? Here's the truth. Tiffany does complain way too much. And you want to know the other truth? Ronald has horrible spending. He's awful with budgeting and with spending and whatnot. He's not amazing at taking care of the kids, but he's okay. And his problem is he's so stubborn. He's so hard-headed. So they're both wrong. Neither of them are doing anything, you know, right in this situation. Tiffany is constantly nitpicking at Ronald, and Ronald doesn't really do a whole lot, so I can barely even stand to watch it. But they went to the zoo, they brought the two kids, it was actually pretty happy, everything was going pretty well. But then Ronald's mom visited, who everyone loves Ronald's mom, you know, grandma, everyone's so happy to see her, she seems very nice, very sweet. And that's when Tiffany opened up to Ronald's mom, and then Ronald saw her opening up to his mom, and then so then Ronald got mad, then Tiffany got mad, then they ended up having a date night. You know, Ronald's mom took the two kids, they went on a date night, and it was completely awful, horrible, disaster, not good. I could barely stand to watch it. It was honestly really awful. And so they were just fighting. They went out to dinner. Ronald ended up just storming off, went on his own. It was miserable to see. I mean, they're not happy together. They can't see eye to eye. So honestly, I guess, you know what? That's the point of divorce. It sucks to see a family get split up and they can't be together, but that is the point of a divorce. You know, they should not be together. That's all, you know? So they were sitting there at dinner. Tiffany was nitpicking him. He was nitpicking her. That's all I'm gonna say. I can't stand to watch it. It is just so negative and so awful. And then so he ran off, and it looks like one way or another, she's gonna take the kids, go back to America, and then we're going to be in present day, and they're going to actually get a divorce. And I was wrong, because we did get to see Asuelu and Kalani, and basically nothing's happening besides the fact that Asuelu's looking at buying a car, Asuelu said that he wants to have more kids, and Asuelu's mom, who got into a gigantically huge fight with Asuelu and Kalani, is now saying she wants to come to see them with you know, Asuelu's sister, Tammy, who got into a huge fight with Kalani. So that was basically it. We're going to have to see how it plays out. It seems kind of ridiculous, but you know, for the two of them, for their actual relationship, Kalani and Asuelu, they're actually doing pretty well. So that was about it, y'all. Quick little sneak peek what we did get to see. Well, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Pretty solid episode. Definitely not bad. A lot of drama. My biggest complaint is like all these couples. They call it the show Happily Ever After, but it's fighting, and I just cannot stand it. Well, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Hit that like button, hit the comments below, and y'all better stay tuned for many more videos.